This 35-foot boat seems set to revolutionise the world of yachting. It was designed by the man who masterminded Australia's America's Cup-winning boat in the 1980s. But the real breakthrough is the way it was created. This yacht began its life with a bang. Incredibly, its aluminium hull was shaped by an explosion of gelignite. For the first time, conventional fiberglass boats could face real competition.
It's an alternative to plastic that for the first time can be taken seriously, in that for the first time you're able to deliver at the economics of production plastic boats the same eye-pleasing round bilge hulls that up till now have not been possible.
Boats made of aluminium, being much lighter and more rigid, have a natural speed advantage over conventional fiberglass yachts. The problem until now was that it's been impossible to work the metal easily and cheaply into the sleek shapes of a racing cruiser. Under the new process, the roughly shaped aluminium parts are put into place in a concrete mould. The mould is then filled with water and carefully measured charges of gelignite put into position. The idea is that the shock wave pushes the metal into its proper hull shape, the whole process taking just 1.5 milliseconds. Because it happens so quickly, the metal loses none of its natural strength, a big advantage for yachts in the fastnet race, for instance.
There's increasingly more jetsam and flotsam out there, and people sailing the standard production plastic fiberglass Tupperware boat, as the Royal Navy refer to them, are confronted with what might happen when they hit this sort of material.
Development of this relatively low-cost technology is especially timely for yachting, as disenchantment grows at the ever-spiralling costs of the America's Cup.
Raul Gardini, the head of the Italian syndicate, has spent something like $75 million. Bill Koch, the head of the American syndicate, has spent at least that on his defenders. Now, how can anyone seriously contemplate spending that much money on a sporting event? It's not on.
If the cost of competition does carry on rising, there's every likelihood that neither Britain nor Australia will be able to afford to compete in the America's Cup again. Already, pressure is beginning to grow here for some kind of spending limit to be introduced. It must be a concern for the future of the event that the only non-American winners are beginning